It doesn't matter what kind of music you take up. If you become at all professional, you will find probably that the most part of your employment comes through the women's musical clubs, in which case you will have to undergo being introduced by the lady president. And I would like to show you what to expect in this respect. Doesn't have to be. It doesn't have to be feathers. It can be birds or fruit. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and others. I'm sorry, of course, I know all our members are ladies and gentlemen. What I meant to say was, some of you have brought friends. It gives me such pleasure to welcome you all to this first concert of the season, sponsored by the Women's Federation for the Propagation of Music and Art. And to introduce the artist that we're going to have this afternoon and present her with this beautiful corsage. But first let me say it's wonderful to see this turnout, because as you know, our organization stands for the better things in art, not expecting either reward or enjoyment. Because we feel that music is so important in our lives, we should all listen to it, even if we don't like it. We should grit our teeth and grin and bear it and try harder. I think Shakespeare summed it up so beautifully in his play, Celius Jusa, where he said... I'm sorry, Julius Caesar. Macbeth. Where he said, if music be the food of love, play on. He didn't say on what, but I think it's a marvelous idea. Because deep down in every one of us there is a certain stagnant something that is dormant. And it makes us feel that we should stand up and get behind ourselves and push ourselves into it. Music, I mean. And so that is why I am here this afternoon to welcome you all and to introduce the artist and present her with this beautiful corsage. Of course, this is really the job of the chairman of entertainment, but she's awfully sorry she was unable to be here this evening. She's been in bed all week with the doctor. I think you're very unkind. She's having a horrible time. And so, before I introduce the artist and present her with this beautiful corsage, I'd like to give out the lecture series from next month. I think it's going to be very interesting. We're going to have Skinwell Oatcake, the well-known Shakespearean actor who will speak on Hamlet the Great Dane. And then our own Mrs. Prendergast has very kindly volunteered to give us a talk for free, which I think is wonderful of her, on how to make patchwork quilts out of old skirts. The reason for this is that the last speaker of the season is going to be excessively expensive, but I'm sure it's going to be worth it. We're going to have a Vogue expert here to speak to us about how to make skirts out of old patchwork quilts. And now it gives me such pleasure to introduce the artist that we're going to have now and present her with this beautiful corsage. It is none other than that magnificent pianist, Miss... Miss Hamburger. Now, Miss Hamburger is one of the greatest exponents of the keyboard today. The New York Times says... Well, it says Hamburger here. Oh, I'm sorry, that's my shopping list. Well, really, she's so well known, I need hardly mention her name. That's practically a household word. Who is it? Oh, of course, it's none other than... Oh, pardon me, this beautiful corsage is bringing on my hay fever. As I was saying, our pianist today is... Oh, my goodness, I'm afraid one of my spells is coming on. I'll have to go, but before I go, I want you to give me... I want you to give our artist a really wonderful welcome. I mean a one... When she comes on, for goodness sake, clap.